Good morning, children, and welcome to all of you online classes. Dear students, we are going to discuss the first poem of Tarun syllabus, and the name of poem is The Voice of the Rain. This poem is from Hornbill book, or this poem has been composed by a great poet of English literature, or his name is Walt Whitman. This poet worked as an essayist, as a generalist, or composed many famous poems. Or this great poet was born on 31st May 1819 at West Hills in Newark. I want to tell you that this great poet Walt Whitman has composed many poems, written many stories, written many essays, and contributed a lot in the field of literature. This great poet died unfortunately on March 26, 1892 in Newark. Now, it was all about the poet. Now we have to discuss about the voice of the rain. The poet here is going to tell about the eternal nature, immortal nature of the rain. Or here poet wants to tell us that rain is eternal, immortal, or it works like other species of our universe. Or here the poet has described the rain as a speaking part. Or poet has described here the strange conversation between him and the rain. Once the poet of this poem, he asked the rain ki who was actually, who it was. The rain gives a beautiful reply that it was the poem, it was the poem, it was the song of the earth. Dear students, that poem and song both gives reposeness and happiness. Here poet has personified the rain. Rain has been described here as a living being. It is speaking. Understood? Our poet is surprised to know that the rain, the soft falling shower, has replied. Or this rain has given reply, and it has given introduction about itself, and it has told the poet about its journey, about its life journey. The rain tells that it is the poem of earth. It tells the poet that it starts from the earth. Rain tells the poet that it starts its journey from the earth. Or it, the birth means, if the poet wants to tell the birthplace of the rain is the earth and the sea. The origin place, the origin point of the rain. Or this beautiful, soft, souring rain is telling about itself that it starts from that sea. Or whenever the sun rays falls on it, on that vast sea, so the process of evaporation starts. Or after that, dear students, the rain, that water which is collected in the sea, it started converting into water vapor. When the sun rays fall on the surface of the sea, or this process of making this process is continuous, enormous. It is a continuous process. So when the sun rays fall on the surface of the sea, the process of evaporation starts. Or finally, dear students, with the help of wind, that water vapor, which is definitely converted after falling the sun rays, with the help of wind, it moves upward. Or finally, it used to collect in the sky in form of clouds. But poet, the rain tells about itself to the poet that this process is continuous process, that making of that water vapor and that evaporation process is continuous, or continuously this process is going on, and that with the help of wind it used to go upwards and it used to gather in the sky in form of clouds. Or finally the rain tells the poet ki whenever there is a requirement, whenever there is a need of rain, requirement of water, requirement of rain to the earth, either to the garden or to the different parts of the earth, where there is a requirement are in the field, the rain comes down in form of that soft, beautiful rain drop. In form of drops it comes down. Or not only this much, it comes down, dear students, but it satisfy and fulfill the need and thrust of different elements of the earth, even the fields, even the desert, even the gardens, even the mountains and valleys. So this beautiful rain satisfy the quench and thirst of different elements of the earth. Or after fulfilling it, then finally, dear students, it gives happiness to the all elements of earth, to the all supposed parts of the earth. It gives reposeness, it gives happiness, it gives greenery. This rain gives greenery and happiness and all these things to the nature whenever it is required. Or ultimately, dear students, this rain slowly goes to its birthplace, to its destination, to its origin place, through the different canals, through different rivers, and finally those rivers are connected with the sea, and it reaches to its birthplace, origin point in the sea. And again the process of this evaporation starts. Or again the clouds are collected there. So means the poet wants to tell that the rain is eternal. This process is forever. It can never be stopped, as we human have to play different parts in our life, first as an infant, then as a young man, then as an old man, and ultimately after completing all the parts we have to die, and again we have to take birth. The same routine of the month, the year starts with January, or ultimately it ends with December, and again January starts. In the same way, this rain also working continuously, It never forgets its origin place. It does not suppose. It never minds whether the people are caring, whether the people are careful. They are caring and feeling its contribution, its touch or not. It works continuously. Or in this cycle, it works that it starts its journey from its origin place and finally, it, with the help of wind, it goes to the sky and collected there in form of clouds, and finally it comes down on the earth to give happiness, to give greenery, to give reposeness, to satisfy the quench and thrust of the different elements of the earth, to make them beautiful, to give them good life and happy life, and ultimately this pure and ever lasting and forever rain, it continues its journey. So this was all about this poem, dear students, and tomorrow I will teach you line by line. Thank you.